Now, how paranoid should people really be? When I send kids off to daycare, I tell them, you know, gosh, if it's a daycare of six or more kids, you're going to have a green runny nose, basically, November through March. Our RSV, we really watch with our premature babies, the respiratory syncytial virus. We give them $1,000 a month injections to prevent it. But do I need to be, well, we used to have pay telephones. I guess we don't anymore. But computer keyboards, and should be opening up doors with my elbow and so forth. I've heard there's more risk getting in a taxi cab in New York than there is actually in touching all these things. So how paranoid should we be? I keep washing my hands every time I see you cough. So in terms of surfaces, is this virus staying in the air for 24 hours, 48 hours? Should we be wrapped in giant plastic bubbles? How paranoid should we be?
Well, we should be concerned, but not paranoid. There are steps we can take to protect ourselves. About the little kids in daycare, the parents and the people, the teachers at daycare, need to keep kids who are sick out. Let me stress that again. They can have their prolonged runny noses, but they should have them at home. You mentioned that the newest bioterrorism weapons, the worst ones, are little kids. And that's true of all of school age as well. Schools, high schools, grammar schools, even colleges, are incubators for the spread of this disease. Kids just carry it around from person to person, and then they break, go home at the end of the day, and they expose family members and other people that they run into. And so those are major concerns. That's one of the steps to take. Again, stressing it, stay home when you're feeling ill.
We have a number of